Welcome to my channel. In this video, we are going to discuss about the third unit MCQ questions from the DSP. The third unit, it is a FIR filter design. So in the previous videos, in second unit, we discussed the IR filter design. Okay, so now we are going to discuss about the third unit questions, FIR filter design. So you know FIR, what is FIR? FIR means it's a finite impulse response filter, okay. So depending upon already, you know, depending upon the impulse response of the filter can be divided into two things. One is IR, another one is FIR. Okay, so IR means infinite impulse response filter. FIR means finite impulse response filter. Okay, so in this, we are going to see about the linear phase FIR filter basics. Okay, so first question you see, which of the following is the difference equation of FIR filter of length M, input X of N and output Y of N. Okay, so you know all discrete time systems are represented by the difference equation. Okay, so for FIR filter of length M, if input is X of N, output is Y of N, which one is the difference equation? Okay, so the difference equation which relates the input and output is this one. Y of n, the output y of n is equal to summation k equal to 0 to m minus 1 bk x of n minus k. So this is the relation between the output and the input of that particular FIR filter. Okay, where this m, k ranges from 0 to m minus 1. So capital M is the length of the filter. Okay, then the next one. So here see, so it's a thing. So where the BK is a set of filter coefficient, X of N is the input, Y of N is the output. So X of N minus K means it's a delayed inputs. Okay, previous inputs. The next question, FIR filter dash, it's a non-recursive, do not adopt any feedback, recursive, use feedback. So the FIR filters are non-recursive, and they do not adopt any feedback. So already we discussed the IR filter. IR filter is a recursive type. Okay, recursive type. And so if it is a recursive, it compulsory uses the feedback. Okay, so feedback means the portion of output is again feedback as an input. But the FIR filter is a non-recursive type. Okay, so non-recursive type, that means the present output does not depend on the past outputs. So it's a non-recursive, so it do not adapt any feedback. Then the next one, an ideal filter should have unit gain in their stop band. The statement is true or false. Ideal filter should have unity gain in stop band. It's a false. In stop band, the gain reaches zero value, not unity gain. Okay, so at stop band, the ideal filter, it should have zero gain at stop band, maximum gain in pass band. So the statement is false. The next thing, the ideal filter should have zero gain in the stop band. Yes, it's a correct only. Okay, so the magnitude, that is, you know, this is the ideal low pass filter response. Okay, so from the frequency 0 to that cutoff frequency, the gain, it is maximum and constant. And after this frequency FC, okay, cutoff frequency, the stop band. Okay, so you see the gain in the stop band is zero. The gain in the pass band is maximum. So this is the correct statement. Then the next one, the envelope delay or group delay is the time delay that the signal component of frequency omega undergoes as it passes from the input to output of the system. So the statement is true or false. This is the true only. Okay, so the time delay taken, that is delay means, you know, the time taken to reach the output of the system from the input. Okay, so it is called as a delay. So in that use, that is this delay is divided into the two thing, envelope delay or group delay. So this envelope delay or group delay is the time delay that the signal component of frequency omega undergoes at is it passes from the input to output of the system. So it's a true statement. Then the next one, if the phase theta of omega of the system is linear, then the group delay of the system is dash. Okay, so if the phase of the system is linear, then group delay of the system is increases with the frequency of the signal. The group delay is a constant, decreases with the frequency of the signal, independent of frequency of the signal. So the group delay, it is a constant. If the phase of the system is linear, what about the group delay? Okay, so you see the relation between this group delay and the phase angle is that the group delay TG of omega, it is nothing but d theta of omega divided by d omega. Okay, so from this we can say that if here they are saying it as the phase of the system is linear. Okay, so linear means what about this rate of change of theta of omega? So if you are differentiating the linear value means we will get the constant. Okay, so that's why if the theta of the phase theta of omega is linear means the group delay is a constant. Okay, so this is the thing. Then the next one, basically group delay is the delayed response of filter as a function of dash. Okay, group delay, the definition, the group delay is the delayed response of filter as a function of phase, amplitude, frequency, all of the above, frequency. Okay, group delay is a delayed response of a filter as a function of frequency. Next one, a filter is said to be linear phase filter if the phase delay and the group delay are dash. Okay, so in which case we can say that the filter is said to be linear phase filter means if the phase delay and the group delay are high, moderate, low, constant, constant. Okay, so for one filter, the phase delay and the group delay are constant means we can say that that filter is a linear phase filter. Okay, or reverse, we can say if the filter is having phase angle is linear, the theta of omega is linear means the phase delay and group delay are constant. Then the next one, dash is defined as the negative ratio of phase and frequency of the filter. Dash is defined as the negative ratio, that is minus phase and frequency of the filter. It's a phase delay. So the phase delay is defined as the negative ratio of phase and frequency of the filter. Okay, so you see the phase delay is nothing but minus of theta of omega divided by omega. So where, what is theta of omega? Theta of omega is nothing but phase. Omega is nothing but frequency. So negative ratio. So minus of the negative ratio of the phase divided by the frequency, it is called as a phase delay. Then the next one, dash is defined as the decrease of phase response with respect to frequency. Okay, so decrease of phase response with respect to frequency. That means it's a group delay. So group delay is nothing but minus of the one-time differentiation of this theta of omega. D theta of omega divided by omega, it is called as a group delay. So the group delay is nothing but decrease of phase response with respect to frequency. Okay, so you just remember these definitions. Phase delay is nothing but negative ratio of phase and frequency of the filter. Group delay is nothing but decrease of phase response with respect to frequency. The next thing, which among the following has or have a provision to support an adaptive filtering mechanism? Okay, so adaptive filtering. Adaptive filtering means the filter coefficient, it may vary automatically with respect to the environment. So for adaptive filtering mechanism, which one is supporting? IIR, FIR, both A and B, none of the above, both A and B. So we can design adaptive IR filter or adaptive FIR filter also. Okay, both can having the provision to support adaptive filtering. Then the next one, the lower and upper limit on convolution sum, okay, reflect the causality and the finite duration characteristics of the filter. It's a true. Okay, so in a convolution sum, okay, convolution sum formula, summation n equal to minus infinity to infinity x of n into h of k h of n minus k. So in that, the lower and upper limit, that is summation n equal to 0 to infinity, means it says causality. then a finite duration. So that's why the lower and upper limit of convolution sum, yes, it reflects the causality and the finite duration characteristics of the filter. It's a true. Then the next question, which of the following condition should the unit sample response, okay, unit sample response of FIR filter satisfy to have a linear phase? So what is the condition? Condition in terms of unit sample response means H of N. Okay, the unit impulse response, we are calling it as a unit sample response. So what is the condition for the FIR filter to be a linear phase FIR filter? Okay, so the condition is that the H of N is equal to, okay, this is the condition, the impulse response H of N is equal to plus or minus H of M minus 1 minus N for the N value between 0 to M minus 1. Okay, where M is the length of that FIR filter. Okay, this is the condition. If this condition is satisfied, means that FIR filter, it is a linear phase FIR filter. H of N equal to plus or minus H of capital M minus 1 minus N. Sometime instead of this capital M, so we may use capital N also. If order of the filter is capital N, okay, while solving the big question, we are taking order of the filter as a capital N. So instead of M, we may use capital N also. Then the next one, if H of Z is the Z transform of impulse response, then which of the following relation is true? Okay, so you know the relation between small h of N and h of Z. If we are taking Z transform for impulse response, we will get h of Z. So h of Z is nothing but transfer function or system function of that particular filter. So which one is true? Okay, which one is true? So the answer is this one, that is the h of Z is equal to Z power minus M minus 1 H of Z inverse. Okay, Z power minus of M minus 1 into H of Z inverse equal to plus or minus H of Z. So for FIR filter, this is the true relation. Since already you know, for linear phase FIR filter, the condition is that H of N equal to plus or minus H of M minus 1 minus N. If you are taking Z transform on both sides, we will get this is the expression. Okay, so this is the condition for linear phase FIR filter. Okay, then the next one, the roots of the polynomial H of Z are identical to the roots of polynomial H of Z inverse. It's a true or false? So H of Z is our system function. H of Z inverse is a that is in the place of Z. If you are replacing Z inverse, we will get H of Z inverse. Okay, it's inverse transfer function. So the roots of H of Z is identical to roots of the polynomial H of Z inverse. It's a true. Okay, so both polynomial, it should have the same roots. Then the next question, what is the value of H of M minus 1 by 2 if the unit sample response is anti-symmetric? Okay, if the unit sample response H of N is anti-symmetric, what is the value of H of M minus 1 divided by 2? So the H of M minus 1 divided by 2, the value is 0. So you see, if the unit sample response is anti-symmetric, means the condition is that H of N equal to minus of H of M minus 1 minus N. Okay, so this is unit sample response is anti-symmetric. So for anti-symmetric, if M is odd, okay, M is odd, the center point of anti-symmetric is, which is equal to 0. Okay, this is equal to 0 value. Then what is the number of filter coefficients that satisfy that specify the frequency response for H of N is symmetric? So what is the number of filter coefficients that specify the frequency response for H of N symmetric? If the H of N is symmetric, the number of filter coefficient that specify the frequency response is M plus 1 by 2. Okay, when M is odd, M by 2 when m is even, the number of filter coefficient, if m is odd, m plus 1 by 2, if m is even, m by 2. So the answer is D. M plus 1 by 2 when m is odd, m by 2 when n is even. Okay. Then what is the number of filter coefficient that specify the frequency response of h of n antisymmetric? Okay, so this question is, if the h of n is symmetric, the number of filter coefficient is this one. If the h of n is antisymmetric, what about the filter coefficient? Okay, so m minus 1 by 2 when m is odd, m by 2 when m is even. Okay, so here m plus 1 by 2, here m minus 1 by 2 for m is even, m by 2 when m is odd. The next thing, which of the following is not suitable either as low pass or high pass filter? Okay, so which of the following is not suitable either as a low pass or high pass filter? H of n symmetric and m is odd, H of n symmetric and m is even, H of n anti-symmetric and m odd, H of n anti-symmetric and m even. Okay, so H of n anti-symmetric and m odd, this is not suitable in order to design low pass or high pass filter. Okay, H of n anti-symmetric and m is odd is not suitable for low pass and high pass filters. The next thing, the anti-symmetric condition with m even is not used in the design of which of the following linear phase FIR filter? The anti-symmetric condition with m even is not used in the design of linear phase FIR filter. Okay, low pass. So this anti-symmetric with m even is not used in the design of low pass filter. Okay. The next thing, the anti-symmetric condition is not used in the design of low pass linear phase FIR filter. Yes. Okay. Anti-symmetric condition is not used in order to design the low pass linear phase FIR filter. Then the next one, which of the following filters have the frequency response as shown below? Okay. So you see here, up to this point too, the gain is maximum. Then the gain reduces. Okay, at one frequency and again constant, reduces constant. It's a band pass filter, band stop, all pass filter, notch filter. So this frequency response, it is called as a notch filter. That is, notch filter means the frequency response characteristics with the nulls at frequency, the two frequency omega naught and omega one. In two frequency, the gain of this filter reaches the minimum value. Okay, that is, it will reject only the two particular frequency. That filter is called as a notch filter. Okay, the narrow band reject filter is called as a notch filter. The next one, the comb filter is a special case of a notch filter in which the nulls occur periodically across the frequency band. Comb filter is a special case of notch filter in which the nulls occur periodically across the frequency band. Yes, it's a true. The comb filter can be viewed as a notch filter in which the nulls occur periodically across the frequency band. Okay, that filter. So one type of notch filter, it is called as a comb filter. Then the next one, the filter with the system function h of z is equal to z power minus k is a dash. Notch filter, band pass filter, all pass filter, none of the mention. So the filter with the system function h of z is equal to z power minus k, it is called as a all pass filter. Okay, h of z is equal to z power minus k, it's a pure delay system. It has constant gain for all frequency. That's why the filter is called as all pass filter. So if the system is having response h of z is equal to z power minus k, it is called as a all pass filter. That means it pass all frequencies. Then if the frequency response of an FIR system is given by h of z is equal to 6 plus z power minus 1 minus z power minus 2, then the system is dash. Minimum phase, maximum phase, mixed phase, none of the mentioned. Okay, it's a minimum phase filter. If the frequency response 6 plus z inverse minus z power 2, minimum phase. So how to calculate it's a minimum phase or maximum phase or mixed phase means, so first we have to factorize this polynomial. Okay, so if we are factorizing, we will get the roots. Okay, that is a, so here the h of z is having only numerator. Okay, numerator. So that's why we will get, we have to find the zeros of the system. So the zeros of the system, we will get, it is a minus 1 by 2 and plus 1 by 3. So the system is called as minimum phase. Okay, minimum phase. Then the next one, if the frequency response of FAR filter is 1 minus z power minus 1 minus 6 into z power minus 2, then the system is called dash. So similarly, you just factorize the given thing. So we find the roots are minus 2 and 3. So the system is called as maximum phase. That is, if the roots, the zeros are greater than 1. Okay, greater than modulus 1 means that system is called as maximum phase. So for this, we will get the zeros, the roots of that numerator polynomial is minus 2, minus 3. So it is called as a maximum phase. So in the previous question, we will get the roots are minus 1 by 2, 1 by 3. So it is less than 1. Okay, less than modulus 1. That's why that system is called as minimum phase. Then the next question, if the frequency response of the system h of z is equal to 1 minus 5 by 2 z inverse minus 3 by 2 z power minus 2, then the system is dash. Okay, similarly, you just factorize this h of z. If you are factorizing, we will get the zeros minus 1 by 2, 3. Okay, so 1 root is greater than 1, 1 is less than 1. So this phase system, it is called as a mixed phase. Okay, 1 0 value is greater than 1, 1 is less than modulus 1. So that's why this type of system, it is called as a mixed phase. Minimum phase, maximum phase, mixed phase. Minimum phase means the zeros of the transfer function is having fractional value. If the value is greater means it is called as a maximum phase. If the two roots are mixing means it is called as a mixed phase. Okay. Then the next question, which method is not suitable to design FIR filter? Bilinear transformation, windowing technique, Fourier series method, frequency sampling method. So bilinear transformation is not suitable to design FIR. Bilinear transformation, it's a method used to design IAR filter. Okay, so we discussed in the previous video. So bilinear transformation, impulse invariant method, matched Z transform. These are all the methods in order to design IAR filter. Okay, so in order to design FIR filter, there is a Fourier series method is there. Different types of windowing technique is there. Frequency sampling methods is there. So these three is used to design FIR. This is not a suitable method. Okay, so in the next video, we will discuss about this different types of design techniques of FIR filter in the next video. Okay, so thanks for watching my channel and please subscribe my channel for more videos. If you want to learn the remaining MCQ videos for this DTSP, I will give link for that videos in the description box. You can refer it. Or if you want to learn the signals and system and antenna and microwave engineering, so already I posted the MCQ videos. So in my channel, so there is a separate playlist is there for signals and system, antenna and microwave engineering and circuit analysis. So for all subject, the videos are there. If you want to learn, you can learn. Okay, so thanks for watching. In the next video, we will meet. Thank you.